Let's go over some general best practices for creating AR. If you're creating an AR experience that allows people to move around, it's important to keep them safe. AR is a blend of the digital world and the real world, so don't cover huge portions of people's vision needlessly. It can be really disorienting, and it may block out important information about what is actually physically around a person, creating hazards. Don't make people walk backwards. It's not only awkward, it's a great way to stumble into something unexpectedly. Onboarding is incredibly important. Remember, many people have never used AR before, so you need to design with beginners in mind. If you're creating something with a large footprint, consider prompting your user to go outside or to a larger open area. This will help set expectations for the space required so people won't have to restart your experience in a more appropriate open place. Don't overload your user with all of the instructions at once. Try to introduce instructions when and where they are needed. Users will be more likely to understand and retain the information. One way of doing this is to create a proximity trigger that then reveals an instruction when the person gets close to that object. Try to keep your overall file size as low as you can. Personally, I shoot for less than 50 megabytes. If it gets too large, it can make the experience harder to share, especially for mobile phones that are often downloading over cellular, and you can start to experience performance challenges. Generally speaking, at the moment, AR experiences are best served in short doses. Users can become fatigued when using AR for extended periods, so try to keep it short and sweet. And last, don't try to recreate VR in AR, meaning don't completely overwrite the physical world. Leverage it. That's what AR does. It augments reality.